pool of talent. Be a good steward of your ability. You either use them or you lose them. So the story of the parable of the 10 talents gives us a lot of lessons. God has given us different talents. You either use your talent or you lose it. Be a good steward with your abilities or you lose them. Don't be afraid to try. You should not be afraid to try. Don't look yourself too low to go out there to do what others are doing. Never say, I have so little. My condition won't matter. Everything, every little thing helps. There's nothing as little in God's eyes. Never look at yourself and say, no, I'm too small. I don't belong there. Or I don't have, what am I going to do in the midst of those people? That's already, you are already devaluing yourself. People may not be equal in talent, but they can surely be equal in effort. We might not be equal in talent, but just the effort made makes a difference. So don't just sit with the talent that God has given you without trying to make a difference with it. The faithful servant gambled with the master's goods in pure blind faith. And that was really what he meant for them to do. The servants, they gambled with that money in blind faith. They were not sure they would make that much more. But because they were willing to take the risk, it yielded fruit. And because they were willing to do everything to satisfy the master promised to give them more. And it's the same thing with God. The more you're hungry for God to do God's work, the more blessings you also receive in God's field. They yet so completely, in other words, that they believe his intention. His spirit. If you will, as they understood it, and gamble themselves on the fulfilling it, which means they had faith and they gambled with their faith, which means they trusted God with what was given to them, and they believe they could do more if they put that what the master gave them into good use. They took a chance. It's like you decided to say, okay, how can I put it? Like what the brother invited you to come and do. That is going into a Muslim community. And you know what it means for a Christian to come and preach in the Muslim community. That man is seeing something different. But when you go there to preach, the people will see something different. But because it's something that what I advise to say is just that before you go into that kind of place, and yeah, you pray over it and go with the Spirit. But that might also be a good sign, because God wants to use you to pass a message. But we must be strong when going there. We don't just walk and say, I'm a child of God, I will just go there and stand up. You will be challenged, you will be surprised what the devil can do in that particular circumstances. It's about taking a risk, but you must trust God. You must go with God. Yes. Because the honest truth is just that what is killing us as Christians is what I'm saying is fear. We do have faith in God, but we are afraid to take risk. We are afraid to take risk. Because you go to deliver God's message, you go to heal somebody, the faith is there, but you are afraid, will the outcome come out true? Will that person be healed? You go with fear. But when you go with total confidence in God, that Christ will use you to heal that person, truly that healing will come. But because of fear, you go there with a good intention. But fear because of the fear, the healing will not come. So we must be courageous when we go out there to do God's work. We must be afraid, because when the devil looks, see just a little opportunity in us to use, that is where he cripples us. So that's why we are saying here that we must be able to take a risk when it comes to our talent, because that is our talent. Like God has given you a talent to evangelize, and we must take risk in certain fields. It's not everywhere that we go that we will find everything just as easy as we. Everybody will be welcome. No, it will not be like that. It's a tough battle, and Christ said it. Many people will be persecuted for my name's sake. We are getting closer to the end of days. If we look at our circumstances, whatever is happening around the world, around us, we can see that we are growing closer to the end of time. We don't know how soon it will be, but from the circumstances and from the way our life on earth is going, the way life is going right now, we can see that slowly, we are getting closer to the end of time. We are now getting closer to the second coming of Christ. And in Matthew 25, it talks about preparing us for the second coming. If you look at that second coming, that Matthew 25, we will see that all these talent things and the message that continues from there, we will see that Christ was talking about the second coming. And that is what we are getting closer now. And the main thing about our message of talent today is, where do you find yourself when Christ comes? What do you think will happen when God comes to judge us? Will you be afraid that we will be cast in the lake of fire? Are we being too cautious when it comes to saving God? Because that's the problem. Some of us are afraid. We are being so cautious. We are afraid to take chances. Some of us are afraid that we might pass the wrong message, and at the end of judgment, God will not find us in his favor, and maybe we will be cast in the lake of fire. Are we afraid to fail? What are we doing our talent? Are we being cautious? Are we afraid to use it? Or are we afraid that we might find ourselves in the wrong side of God on the last day? Why are we afraid to use our talent? The parable of talent was meant to encourage us to be bold, to take risk, just like these servants. Those are the two servants did to deal with the 10 bags of money and the two bags of money. So the main focus of our message today is about our talent, and the question is, what are we doing with our talents? Are we using them to save God, or are we afraid to use them? It is clear that we all have talents to do things in different fields or in different denominations. But the question is, how aware are we using those talents? How are we using those talents to save God? Is your talent riches? How are you using your riches to help God's work move forward? Is your talent singing? How are you using your voice to glorify God? Is your talent to preach the message? How are you using that talent to pass the message of good news to God's children? So, the main focus of our message today is for us to take the chance. It's for us to take the risk. As they say, no risk, no gain. Use our talent to save God. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Because when you go out there to do anything in God's name, God will deal with you and God will use you in ways that you yourself will be surprised. Never give up. Feel free. If you see somebody who is out there who is lost, don't be afraid to walk with that person and just start a conversation and then maybe tell him about Christ. They don't even know anything about Christ. And we must share our message with love. Because honest truth is just that everything about the Bible is surrounded around love. You can't do God's word without love. Love is the most important thing. It conquers everything. To get a Christian to come fellowship in your church, you need to exercise love. You cannot just go and tell it that, hey, our church is a very good church, we bring the true message of God, or this and this. No. You must give that Christian a reason why you should come to that particular church. What is it so particular about that church? And the most important thing about it is love. A church where we love one another, where we treat each other as a family, where we treat each other as brothers and sisters, where there is no difference among us. That is what Jesus wants. That is the sole message about the gospel. Love. Because I believe if all the churches we have around here, if all the ministries in the world that are going to the world was all centered about under love, I think we would have said that Christ has conquered the world. Then we all go into God's world. People go there because of different reasons. Today it's surprising that pastors submit CVs to get good jobs in church. Where before will you hear that the pastor needs to submit a CV to go do God's work? So we are in a difficult world right now. So we just need to thank God and go out there and use our God's given talent. We should not be afraid. Before me standing here, if they could tell me that I would one day stand in front and talk to people, I never had the courage. But the honest truth is just that when I stood in front the first day, God spoke to me. I was surprised at the end of the day. Even the first day they called me to come and give a prayer, I was like shivering. I was asking myself, how am I going to even start to pray? But I was surprised that immediately as I opened my mouth, it just flowed out. That is how God works. Don't be afraid to use your talent. Go out there and conquer more souls for Christ. Amen. I will invite my pastor to pray for us and to summarize this message in a way that all of us will go back home and with something in mind. Because the honest truth is that many of us come to church after preaching, we go back home, we cannot even remember what the pastor preached or what was the real essence of the message. What was the message in the pastor for? Today was about our talent, the gift God has given us, how well we need to use it.
You've heard God has spoken in diverse ways, and there were some key words that kept repeating, and other key words were emphasized. They may not have been repeated many times, but they were emphasized. We are hearing about our talents. Our talents are the abilities that God has given us to serve Him. Any ability, whether it be keeping the church clean, there's an anointing for the one who keeps the church clean. Whether it be taking care of children, we look at our children, they're scattered. We have been crying here, passing papers round, put your name. Do you want to work with children? Nobody. But people are sitting here with talents that can take care of kids. And they're just sitting. So the preacher is saying, we need to use our talents. And that all of us here have talents. And he has used the words risk over and over and over. And he emphasized the word time. Many of us don't serve God because we don't even have time. Before you can teach these children to understand, I tell you, these children are not, I had the children for long in Sunday school, teaching Sunday school, before I even came up to a pastor. One of the most delicate group of people to lead to Christ, to help to know Christ are children. And if you don't love the Lord, if you are not an example, forget, you play religion in those children. People who bring up children in the fear of the Lord are people who have dared to serve. People who have given themselves to Christ, like so out for Christ. Those are the people who can minister to kids. But Jesus said, if somebody is not like the child, cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. How can you go and teach these children in the way you are? Just get up. Many people think that children want to get up in the morning. Clap for Jesus. With Jesus. And
is most difficult. If you want to lead his children to Christ, you must be a man, a woman of God. Just like that. Some of us is take duketry work to serve water. That's a talent. And many times God start with the little things to play this drum. We see the people playing the drum here. They are great masters of God. They want to play this piano. You come there, you say, God, anoint my hands. I can't play religion. Yeah, anoint. When you touch the keyboard, you don't know what God is doing there. This matter of talent is so serious, brethren. And he talks about taking risk. If you don't, first of all, risk your time. He said about risking your time and risk. It's about time, availability. Yes, I can do this thing, but I'm not available. I can play the piano, I'm not available even to practice. I can keep the church clean, I'm not available. I can save this water, but I'm not available. You have been moving last week. God has been speaking, those who have ears. Last week, God spoke to us and said, remove the wax in their ears and hear. It was very prophetic, about 15 minutes preaching here. If you don't hear God, you never hear, please. And he said, last week, the message was, don't warm the benches. Today is use your talent. What do you think God is doing? I'm coming soon to reward those according to what they have done for me, brethren, don't sin and warm the chairs. And he said, don't fear. Many of us fear. Some of us fear to preach because we are living in sin. We are afraid that they will say, hey, what is he preaching? I know you are that girl. I know you are that boy. I know you are a drunkard. I know you are a smoker. What are you saying? The preacher said, don't fear. Today, drop down sins. And start preaching. They want to talk. You know how you can conquer. You start preaching without saying, when they want to talk, say, my yesterday, God has taken cigarette. You are saying, I don't even know how God will do it. Before you realize, you don't do it again. Because you took the boldness and go and said, enough is enough. I'm not being a slave to this thing. I'm going to preach the gospel. I'm going to shine the light. Hallelujah. And please, if you are here, you have not given your life to Jesus as a Lord King. The talents are not for religious people. You are giving your life to Jesus first. That's the first thing. And then the second, you are sitting there. You have gift that God has put in you. You keep procrastinating. I will. What before will the trumpet sound? You see what happened to the man with the one talent as they read from the word of God. He was thrown to what? Where was he sent to? The man who had the one talent who accused the master and said, you harvest where you do not sow. I knew you were that kind of master. You are a hard master. You harvest where you do not sow. So I went and dug the ground and bury your gift. This is it. What did the master tell the servant? What did he say? Brother Augustine, what did the master say?
The master.
Into what does that mean to you? Hell! You are a born-again child of God. You have a gift. You're not serving God. Somewhere. Someday I read and meditate on this word and say, no, God, I can't believe it. It cannot be true, but it's true. I said, how can I be born again? You sent me to hell. I had a vision. I was going to hell. And I knew I loved the Lord in my heart, in that vision. Just permit me to say this thing. I knew in that vision I loved the Lord. And I stood in that vision. They were raptured. The kids were raptured. The pastor who sat in front like that was a convention with their big backs. Their backs were intact. They've gone. Hey, then I saw her sister's name, Estella Tikumi. She's married to a pastor now. The notebook was there and the pen, she's gone. Hey, I was standing on the window before I looked. All these things are happening in the twinkle of an eye. The kids that I was preparing to the Lord wanted to change my assignment from that of Sunday school to another thing. I was stubborn. So the kids that I was struggling to leave, they all went. And I stood there. Only very few ladies were there. You know, when the top was signed, not all of us would go, but I wish all of us could go. It's my cry, let all of us sit here and go. So the people were in the church, they were just moving around. I entered the church, I said, I asked them, do you know what has happened? They were ignorant. I went outside and said, no, God, this is not fair. I love you so much. And in that dream, I know I love the Lord. I was zealous for you. I said, why have you not taken me? I move around, I see people buying a lot of crazy places where dark. They were rushing up and down. I came back and I stood in front of the church. I lifted up my hands and said, Lord, rapture me. Something dragged me. Rapture me. Something. The Lord said, I call you to do this assignment. You were not doing it. That's why I've left you. I woke up. I asked people, is it true? Can it happen like this? Because I knew the Lord. I love the Lord. Can it be true? Can it happen like this? I went to the Bible and saw that it was true. You can be left behind because you're not using your talent for God. Want us to pray, begin to pray for yourself. Begin to pray, say, Lord.